Hi, my name is Hamid. I'm instructor at ASM Educational Center. Today, I'm going to talk about inter-VLAN communication or route on sticks. Last class, we talked about remember we have a VLAN 2, VLAN 3. So we have our switch, we created two VLAN. This was sales VLAN 10.10.10.0 and this was 20.20.0. Now, at the beginning, these guys can talk and these guys can talk. In order these guys talk, we put a router there, which make these guys can talk across each other, okay? But as you know, that some of the router has this has a two F00 and F01. It has a two fast Ethernet. But as our VLAN get stronger, as our VLAN get larger, we cannot use this concept because we run out of the spot. So what Cisco came with the idea is called route on stick. That means you're gonna have one link here connected. This can be trunk. It has to be trunk because the VLAN has to propagate that. And then we're gonna use the concept of a sub interface. That's what we explain here too. We said a trunk can carry traffic between multiple VLANs. So if you remove the two links going to the router from the switch and replace it with one link configured as a trunk, it will be able to carry traffic from different VLAN to that. Since we cannot do that, and remember all of these, they need to have a default gateway. So what you have to do, we have to use something called sub interface. So that means under this router, we're gonna do as follows. We're gonna have this kind of diagram, and we're gonna show you right now. So again, we have this VLAN and this VLAN, then we're gonna create sub interface, like INT F00.2, IP address 10.10.10.100. This IP address match for this default gateway, and INT F03 IP address 2020.100, that IP address asks for this default gateway. So I cannot use a physical interface, I have to use what? Sub interface. That's what we said right here in our notes, okay? The solution is using sub interface. A sub interface is a virtual interface. The number of sub interfaces is limited by hardware, such as amount of RAM. But theoretically, you could have so many sub interfaces. For each VLAN, we create a sub interface. Tell the sub interface which VLAN is associated with, and assign the default gateway IP to that VLAN so that sub interface can use that. This is known as what? Route on stick, okay? Now you have to understand this concept is going to be used on the Cisco exam, but down the road, instead of using this concept, we're using multi-layer switch. But I want to make sure you cover this because this concept, route on stick, is going to be used in Cisco voice tool. So even it might be phasing out in real world, but you have to know it for Cisco to CCNA voice. Okay, so let's go to our router right now. This is our diagram is, okay? We have a switch, VLAN 2, VLAN 3. We already configured a VLAN here. So let me go here and show you what we have. So if I go here inside the switch, first I show VLAN brief, you see I have a two VLAN. VLAN 2, the ports what? 1 and 2. So PC1, connect 1, and PC2, connect port 2. And then VLAN 3 EGR is port what? 4 and 5 is, okay? So this is port 4 right here, and that's port what? 5. Now if I go to the my PC, I can check it, make sure everything's okay. So I'm going to type in IP config. That's my IP address, ping 10.10.10.2. So I'm pinging my other side, okay? Then I go back here, this is PC4. I'm going to type in IP config. As you see, this is 2020 network is right here. So I'm going to check to see if I can ping that as a ping 20.20.20.5. So right now, these PCs they can talk, and that's why is that? Because right here, because they're same VLAN. But PC1 ping 20.20.20.4. It cannot ping PC1, cannot ping PC4. Why? Because we have to configure router or router on stick, okay? Now the key is whenever you want to router on stick, you have to make sure this link is what? A trunk is, okay? So that's what I said in my notes. When I go to my notes, the first thing we want to do, we need to make sure that our port F024 is a trunk link. And we're going to use 802.1q as a trunk encapsulation. Okay, we have two kind of encapsulation. We have 802.1q or ISS. So this link has to be trunk, and this is F024, okay? So I'm gonna go here to my router. I'm set to my switch. So I'm gonna say config t int /24. Why 24? Because that's a port 24 is connected. Now the key is always remember, always you start with the switch port question mark. When I put a switch port question mark, you want to focus your eyes on the mode and trunk. It's only mode and what trunk. Now look what happened here. I'm going to show you a mistake then so that you will see that. I said mode question mark, then I need what? Trunk. I need what? Trunk. Question mark enter. As soon as I do that, I get an error. This means that first I have to do what? Trunk encapsulation, okay? Because it cannot work. So you gotta go back again. You're gonna type like this. Switch port. Question mark, you gotta do this word first. Trunk. Question mark, then I need what? Encapsulation. Question mark, then I need what? Dot one Q, question mark, enter. Then I use upper key, switch port, mode, trunk, okay? Now if I say show run, I go all the way down to F024. This is the command you need. Switch for trunk encapsulation and that one. Now if I type in show int trunk, let's see if I see something. There's no trunk here. Why is that? Because this port is connected to my what? Router. I have to make sure this port is what? Up and up. As you see, it's red. So I go to router, I go to CLI. Just a note here, enable, config t, let's say no IP domain dash lookup, so I don't waste my time. Then I'm going to say int what, F00, no what, shut. So you have to bring it down, okay? Now I go back to my switch. If I go back to the switch, if I say show int trunk, I see I have a trunk, which is good. So F024 is what? Trunk. And it's 8.1Q. That means all the VLAN get propagated to that one, okay? That's the first thing you have to do. You have to make sure that this link is strong. On the Cisco exam, anytime you see a switch in the router, always remember about router and stick. That's the key things here, okay? All right, now back to our notes. Oops, sorry about that. Right here. Okay, so we did this right here. We said no trunk, all of that good stuff, okay? So, exit. Now, what I'm gonna do after we bring our interface up, we're gonna create a sub-interface and indicate which VLAN they belong to. We assign the default gateway IPs to that related interface, okay? Now, we go back to the router right now. Back to router. So I'm gonna say what? Config T. Now watch this, intf0/0. Question mark. See, with no space question mark, I can use so many sub interfaces. But what number do I use? It does not matter. But for simplicity, since this is VLAN 2, I'm going to use what? Number what? 2. 2. Okay? Then it's good to give description. I said description. This will act as default gateway for VLAN. As default gateway for default gateway equal 10.10.10.100 for VLAN 2. That's first thing. Then what you do, you have to say encapsulation question mark. What I need? .1Q question mark. What I need? The VLAN ID number. This is very important. This VLAN must match with this VLAN, otherwise not going to VLAN what? 2. Okay. Control Z, let's check the work. Show run. Oh, I forget something else. I'm sorry. I gotta give what? IPS config T. INT, let's use upper key. That. Then I'm gonna say what? IP address 10.10.10.100. This is key for the exam. This IP address has to match with what? My default gateway. Then subnet mask. 255.255.255.0. So let's check it right now. Show run. I come down. Here's the keys. The key is under F00, there's no interface, no IP address, but this is for your sub interface. Now I get to do the same thing for what? VLAN 3. So I'm going to use this as my guideline right here. So I'm going to say what? Config T. INTF00.3, okay? Switch port. I'm sorry. I'm gonna say description. This will act as default gateway, which is equal what? Default gateway in our case, we equal what? 20.20.100 20.20.20.100 for VLAN what? 3. Okay? Now watch this. Let me give some error. If I type in IP address 20.20.20.100 255.255.255.0. When I do that, it's going to be error. It need to have what? Encapsulation. It need to what? Encapsulation. So first you have to type in what? Encapsulation question mark dot one Q question mark VLAN number what? VLAN ID number what? ID number 3 will be same as here, which is VLAN 3. Then you gotta upper use IP address. So remember that first you gotta do this statement and that statement. Now control Z, let's use show run. Okay, now again, look what happened. Under FC0 there is no IP address. This will be what? Talking. This IP address better be same as what? VLAN 2. And this IP address will be better like here. Now let's say show IP int brief. Show IP int what? Brief. Here's one more time. I want to make sure you understand that. Remember that never physical IPs, you get a get IP address. But you give IP address to sub interface like that, okay? Another command you can type in what? Show what? IP what? Route. As you see, I have two connected. Network 10 connected to my FAST002, that's VLAN 2 is, and this is VLAN 3. Again, for simplicity, dot 2 means what? VLAN 2. Dot 3 means what? VLAN 3. So this act as a default gateway for this guy, for VLAN 2, and 2020 would act as a what? Default gateway for that guy, okay? So that's what we did in our what? Notes right here. We did all of that right here, okay? Again, the numbering of that must match VLAN number. This is recommend that. So I do INTF03, I do the encapsulation.1Q, then I do IP address and so on and in, okay? And when I say show IP route, I see I'm connected here. Now I'm gonna go to my PC and try to test it. Right now PC1, I could not what? Ping. I use the upper key. See when I say IP config, I'm at the what? Network 10 is right now. But I'm gonna ping 2020.4. Let's see if it works. Okay. So let's see that working. All right, I have connectivity. So what happened? We conclude that these guys were in the same VLAN. You already talked about, you gotta use what? Sub interface, okay? So the most important part is, in case, let's say I create another VLAN. Let's say I have VLAN 4. I create another VLAN. VLAN 4 will be like 30.0.255.255.0 and 30.30.30.1 has default gateway. You gotta go say what? INTF00.4, encapsulation.1Q4, IP address 30.30.100, blah, blah, blah. So that's the way it goes. So here, these guys can talk. Now, in real world, we don't use these two guys. In real world, I'm going to show you another video. These guys are going to come together and we're going to use multi-layer switch. But again, this concept is very important for to understand your CCNA voice and also route on SIG and also the CCNA exam also. And also, I want to show you that, let me go here. We're going to have all of these in our webpage. If you go to asme.com, I'm going to have all of these under what? YouTube's. I'm sorry, on the blogs, CCNA, okay? We're gonna have a bunch of stuff here. Everything is gonna be here. Like we have a bunch of CCNA questions, we have a tip, CCNA exam, like basic router configuration, CCNA switch, CCNA router tips, extended access list, access, all of that is gonna be here. Let's say for OSP, when I click here, not only you will see the type and command line, also you're going to see that video. Now if you have any question or any comment, you can comment to our site and check our website. This is our phone number 301-984-7401, or you can check out our Snapchat, YouTube, Google Plus, Pinterest, Instagram, and everybody, and Facebook. So we try to add as much as we can. Again, thanks so much for your time and have a good day. And the next video, I'm going to talk about multi-layer switch. Thank you. Have a good day.